Apple's back with the smallest iPod ever. Hi, everybody. I'm Jason Snell, and I'm here with three generations of the iPod Shuffle. Now, a few years ago, Apple turned a lot of heads when it came up with an MP3 player that didn't have a display at all. It was the iPod Shuffle, the original model. You press play, things would shuffle, that was it. And then a couple years later, they followed it up with an even smaller model, still has controls on it, and a built-in clip. But that's it, no display, nothing like that. Well, now Apple has released the third generation iPod Shuffle, and they've made some dramatic changes. It's even smaller, but the biggest thing you'll notice about it is it doesn't have any on-device controls. All the controls beyond an on-off switch have moved to the headphones themselves. Now, this poses some interesting issues, but the addition of a spoken interface makes this a very intriguing product, so we're going to show it to you today. Well, let me show you how this works. In order to do that, I actually have to put the earbuds in my ears because all the controls for this thing are right here on the headphones themselves. I should say, Apple also makes a set of in-ear headphones that have the same controller, so if you don't like Apple's earbuds, you can try those. And a bunch of third-party companies will be coming out with adapters and their own brands of headsets that have this controller. This controller is also compatible with the latest generation of iPod Nano, Touch, and Classic, so it's not just the Shuffle, although it's not compatible with the iPhone. Your iPhone headphones won't control this new Shuffle. Anyway, using these controls is actually very easy. The center button, if you click it once, will play. Click it again, will pause. The up button, right above it, will increase your volume. The down button will decrease your volume. Pretty simple. Double-click the center button, advance to the next track. Triple-click, go to the previous track. Where it gets interesting is when you have the iPod Shuffle talk to you. If you hold down the button while it's playing a track, the iPod Shuffle will actually speak the name of the track and the artist of that track. It's pretty cool. It does this by scanning all of your tracks on your computer and translating them all using computerized text-to-speech, and then it loads those sounds on the iPod. If you keep holding, after it reaches the end of the name of the track, it'll beep. And then you let go of the button, and it will start going through all the playlists that are on this iPod. This is a big change from previous iPod Shuffles, which only had a single playlist. Since it's a 4 gigabyte device, you probably want to load it up with a bunch of different playlists because that's a lot of space. There's a lot of songs that can fit on here. As it's reading the playlists that are on it, and it's reading them out loud right through your headphones, you click when you find a playlist that you want. You can even use the up and down buttons to rapidly advance through the list. You find a playlist you want, you press the button again, and that playlist instantly starts playing. Of course, this thing is so small that it doesn't have a USB port on it. For that, Apple includes this little device. It's got a USB plug on one side and a mini jack on the other. You plug it into the headphone jack on the iPod Shuffle, and it connects to your computer via USB. Now, if you're somebody who uses an iPod to listen to music in the car, let's say, you may be wondering, how are you going to get this to work if you have to control it with the headphones? Apple's got a workaround. It's not an ideal workaround, but it does have a workaround. Basically, what you do is you can pick your playlist and volume using the headphones, and then when you unplug and then plug in the cable that's going to your car's auxiliary port, after a few seconds, the iPod will autoplay. It will just start playing, and it will pick up from the playlist that you'd selected at the volume you'd selected. So it's not ideal, but it will get you through if you've got a set of headphones. Now, this brings me to my big criticism of this product, which is you've got to really like Apple's headphones to use it. It comes with this set of headphones that I'm wearing now, and if you've always used the headphones that Apple gives you and you've never had any problems, this product is for you. If you're a bit of a headphone snob and think that Apple's headphones aren't good enough, they don't sound good, they don't stick in your ears, you might not want to bother. For the cost of buying an adapter to use it with the Shuffle, you might just invest that money in buying an iPod Nano instead, where you can control it all using any headphones you want by using the on-screen controls of the iPod Nano. So if you like Apple's headphones, you don't mind them, and you want a low-cost, easy-to-use MP3 player, 4 gigabytes for $79, I think the iPod Shuffle is very compelling, but you've got to like Apple's headphones, or it's not really worth it. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this look at the iPod Shuffle. I'm Jason Snell. Thanks for watching.